In this video, I'm gonna cover three things. First, I'm gonna talk about how I spent the last month studying Spanish, and then in the second part, I'm gonna try to talk a little bit in Spanish so you can see how much I know. It's all gonna have translations in English. And then in the third part, I'm gonna go out and find somebody to talk to in Spanish so you can see how much I really know when talking to somebody in person. All right, so let's get straight into it. I lived in the US, I studied Spanish on my own, and I spent probably about an hour a day as frequently as I could. I missed some days, but I used Duolingo to study. I tried to read some books, a lot of them didn't make sense. I used elementary school books and like children's books. Some of those made sense, and I was learning pretty good, but I didn't even know the existence of like verb conjugation and like different tenses, like subjunctive and imperfect and things like that. So for example, when you conjugate the verb ir, ir means to go, and in present tense you conjugate it as voy, vas, va, vamos, van. In past tense it's gonna be fui, fuiste, fue, fuimos, and fueron. And in future, iré, irás, irá, iramos, irán. Okay, so you have to know how to conjugate these verbs, right? And there's about 17 irregular verbs, and I didn't even know that this whole concept existed. So when I first got here, I could speak a little bit, you know, I could talk to people and be like, yo, ¿dónde está el baño? Or something like that, like some simple stuff. And I could probably get around like pretty easily. But you know, I wasn't really doing it for me. I wanted to learn more. So I started taking Spanish lessons in Mexico City, where I flew into. I took Spanish lessons for 1 week, and then I met a girl, went to live with her for like a week, basically stayed at her house and talked to her parents. Everybody spoke Spanish, nobody spoke English, only Spanish. So living with them, it was kind of humiliating at first. It was very embarrassing, the lack of Spanish knowledge that I had, but I was able to pick up a lot of vocab and just like different things to say that were commonly said. Then I got into Guatemala and I started taking Spanish lessons like more seriously. So I took 2 weeks of Spanish lessons here in Guatemala in San Pedro, Lake Atitlan, and it's been super good. So I think I've learned a lot now. I think I've learned a lot more, at least. I definitely have a lot to go. My eyes are open to where I need to be in the future, what I need to study, and just like how much effort it takes. It's a lot more effort than I thought it was going to be, for sure. All right, so without further ado, let's just get straight into me actually speaking a little bit so you can see kind of like where I am after 1 month. All right, so this part is gonna be mainly infinitive, which is like the present tense, because that's really the easiest and I think I could get like the most done. I'll throw in some past tense and some future tense for sure. So let's do this from Spanish from here on out. Estoy aquí en San Pedro de Guatemala. Y es muy divertido aquí. Hay muchas cosas a hacer, pero solo tengo como dos, tres amigos, porque mucho de tiempo yo estaré estudiando. Es muy difícil para aprender español aquí. Aquí hay hay maestros quien tomar los trabajos muy serioso y hay duro los clases, pero es poco a poco muy lento. En los Estados Unidos, yo tuve solo clases en secundaria y primaria, y no sentí que mi nivel fue suficiente, pero estoy feliz ahora. Creo que, o pienso que en el futuro yo sabré mucho. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna have a small conversation in Spanish. This is Luis, and I met him here in Guatemala, and we've been having a good time playing basketball and stuff together, but we're gonna have a conversation in Spanish, or try to. Okay, so, ¿qué fue el día, Luis?
Mi día fue muy largo. Fueron 8 horas de trabajo, pero fue muy bueno. ¿Y el tuyo?
Mi día fue bien. Yo tomé clases en la mañana por 4 horas de 8 a 12 y después yo fui a beber y alcanzar, no sé. Yo estudié un poco más. Yo he estudiado mucho en San Pedro, como tú sabes, sí. ¿qué piensas tú puedes hacer después jugando baloncesto?
Okay. Ahora no tengo planes, pero yo necesito que tú aprendas más español porque utilizas muchos errores todavía. Pero yo sé que si tú practicas, estarás mejor. Y creo que tu maestra ha sido muy buena porque el primer día que estuviste, hablamos y montaste caballo un fin de semana, ese día pues tu español era más o menos y ahora es como más que menos. Entonces estás mejorando mucho y yo espero que tú aprendas muchísimo.
Okay, gracias. Okay, so that's it. Short conversation, probably still hard for me, but learned a lot. So
you're gonna be great, son. I know.
All right, we'll end it here. Thanks, guys. Alright guys, so I hope you enjoyed the video. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button because next month I'm dropping How Much Will You Know After 2 months of studying Spanish. I'll be studying all the time until then. Drop a comment if you want to see something different, if you want to correct me on some of the Spanish, please go ahead. Alright, we'll see you guys next time.